We've always defined ourselves by the ability to overcome the impossible. And we count these moments. These moments when we dared to aim higher, to break barriers, to reach for the stars, to make the unknown known. We count these moments as our proudest achievements. But we lost all that. Or perhaps we've just forgotten that we are still pioneers, that we've barely begun, and that our greatest accomplishments cannot be behind us, because our destiny lies above us.
This is a war.
They call it La Decima, and its pursuit is an obsession at Real Madrid.
Now consider the alternative. What if tomorrow the war could be over? Isn't that worth fighting for? Isn't that worth dying for?
It's like a commando field of play.
That's good. 9 goals in the group games, more than anybody before him.
Living with Sparta later.
You know, Dutch forces in the game. Dutch forces in the game.
No doubt about the biggest transfer of this summer. Confirmation a short time ago that Gareth Bale is joining Real Madrid.
The rumor in the tradition has been a better than the coach.
Encontrar estos días las claves para frenar el contragolpe.
Cristiano Ronaldo, 3-0 Real Madrid. Wow. Unstoppable. It's the perfect ending to the perfect night. And it's in. It's Sergio Ramos again. He scored twice in 4 minutes. And probably taken Real Madrid to their first Champions League final for 12 years.
This for Real Madrid, this competition, and I agree with you that it's very close the line from the obsession and the dream, but depends your thought what is, and our thought, my thought is a dream.
For the first time in this competition, we have a final involving two teams from the same city.
to watch. Modric takes.
No solo mío, de todos los madridistas, de toda mi familia, de mi mujer, de mi niño, de todos que han estado apoyándonos hasta el final. ¡Viva el Madrid! ¡Viva Cama! ¡Viva Sevilla! ¡Viva Andalucía! ¡Viva España!
Nosotros sabemos cómo hemos dejado todo en el campo para dar la alegría a la afición.